morning, everyone. Welcome to downtown beautiful Sarasota. We're grateful to be here again this year. I'm Melissa Wandle with the National Coalition for Safer Roads and Target Zero Florida. And standing next to me is Cooper. He's been the ambassador for White Cane Day for the last 3 years, I think, right? Yeah, so you're gonna get to hear from him in just a little bit on why he's here. And we're excited to have the city and the chief come out this morning to celebrate White Cane Day. White Cane Day was actually established in 1964 by President Lyndon Johnson. He established today to raise awareness of the white cane and the importance of what the white cane is, which you'll hear here a little bit more today from Cooper. What the White Cane Day is and why it's so important and valuable to a visually impaired and blind person. Today is a celebration as we gather to honor this day to educate our community on why it is critical to drive mindfully. We already know that we have to watch out for our pedestrians and our bicyclists. Of course, the bicyclists share our roads with us, and we need to make sure that they're doing everything correctly. But we have vulnerable road users, which is a pedestrian anyway, but then we have our most vulnerable road users of all, which is our visually impaired and blind that are sharing our roadways with us. Our visually impaired and blind are our most vulnerable road users, and Target Zero Florida identifies dangerous driving behaviors and offers direct countermeasures and messaging to change and drive improvers' actions, making all our Florida roadways safer. They navigate our crosswalks daily, most times with a cane, and they deserve to walk safely without walking in the path of an unsafe driver. In Florida, it is a law that everybody has to stop for a white caner. On behalf of the National Coalition for Safer Roads and Target Zero Florida, we are thrilled to be here today, partnering with FDOT District 1, Sarasota PD, Lighthouse Vision Loss and Education Center, and MAD. Today, our speakers include our 12-year-old ambassador, Cooper, his amazing mom, Tina Vollmer, Chief Trochet, Mayor Kyle Petit, Keith Robbins from FDOT District 1, he's our safety director, Denise McAllister with MAD. We're so excited that MAD is joining us this year. They're our new partner in this adventure. Alexandra Alvin Foley, she is the CEO of the White House Vision Loss and Education Center. We also are going to have a couple of people. We've got Mayor Elkhart and Commissioner Ahern Koch, who they are going to use the vision goggles that we'll talk about a little bit later to walk around the block. A special thank you to them for taking the time to wear these goggles. A special thank you to Sarasota PD's Community Response Unit. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Thank you so much for being here and for setting up for us, for making sure we all have water, and making sure that we're gonna get around the block safely. We appreciate you all and your time. A special thank you to the media for being out here today, and to
important to remind everyone in our community of the role and responsibility that we share to keep our blind and visually impaired pedestrians safe. The state of Florida is a law. When a pedestrian is crossing or attempting to cross a street, guided by a dog guide or carrying a cane or walking stick, the driver of the vehicle must come to a complete stop before entering that intersection. When we all understand the rules of the road, we create safer streets for everyone. Our children, bicyclists, pedestrians, and especially those who are most vulnerable. As adults, sometimes we forget about our observant children, and we need to be cognizant of our own actions, especially behind the steering wheel. If children see their parents driving distracted or failing to yield to any pedestrians, our children are going to learn from our choices. But if we can teach them now, they will have a better understanding down the road, pun intended, of the importance of obeying our traffic laws for the betterment of everyone. Events such as this should not just be a reminder for today, but should be a reminder for every day to watch for those around us. Our agency hosts numerous traffic-related events in the city throughout the year. Our officers are in the community, making sure our streets and our roadways are safe for everyone, and to ensure you arrive safely to your destination. With that being said, at this time I'd like to introduce Mayor Kyle Betty. Thanks.
Of our city, and that we're welcoming of all this diversity in our city. White Cane Day represents strength, courage, and resiliency. And these people exemplify that each and every day. They demonstrate that those things that we see as challenges and obstacles are only limitations if we allow them to be. So my hat's off if I have one. But I applaud each and every one of them for being examples of each and every one of us. Just doing something simple as navigating your way through the city and crossing the street. Something that comes natural to a lot of us, but not to some of us. So with that, I say thank you so very much. And I'd like to read this proclamation on behalf of the city of Sarasota. Whereas it is the right of all pedestrians who are blind, using a guide dog, a service dog, a walker, a crutch, an orthopedic cane, or a wheelchair to access streets and roads. Whereas Florida Statutes 316.1301 and 316.1303 clearly states that drivers must stop to allow pedestrians to cross. Whereas the white cane, by allowing every person, blind person, to move freely and safely from place to place, makes it possible for the blind to fully participate and contribute to our society and live their lives as they want. And whereas increased knowledge, education, and the laws make more pedestrians in this city a friendly community. Now, therefore, the City Commission of this great city of Sarasota, Florida, on behalf of the great citizens of our great community, take great pride in recognizing October 15, 2023 as White Cane Safety Day, a day of special importance and worthy of the recognition of the residents of this great city.
We're gonna get a quick photo op here with this proclamation with Cooper and the mayor. And the chief.